one day away by jet clipper lies the fabled land of Thailand. In fact, Thailand means land of the free. Crisscrossing the countryside and running through the city like Venetian streets are hundreds of canals and give tourists an inside look at a unique country. The beaches are most inviting, and you can study a variety of types. Not many Americans and Europeans, but Western influences are becoming more apparent everywhere. It all seems a fantasy, but it's there and waiting for the modern traveler. A dream come to life.
Thailand has made its mark as a major tourist destination with visitors from around the world, attracting over 20 million tourists in 2012 alone. As a fast-developing nation, Thailand is a dichotomy amongst itself, with one foot firmly planted in its colorful Buddhist roots and the other moving fiercely into the modern future. For young travelers on the Southeast Asian backpacking trail, Thailand is an essential stop for both affordable adventure and easy access to nature and culture. In the southern island of Koh Phangan, a monthly beach party held on every full moon has been raging for 20 plus years, gaining the momentum and popularity to simply be called Thailand's Full Moon Party. Over the years, crowds have grown from 30 to 30,000. And with its fame came urban myths trickling back to the West that the party produced so much trash, much was swept out with the tide by dawn, both polluting and altering this tropical landscape.
We are husband and wife Ben and Shana, and we came to Koh Phangan from Los Angeles, California to witness the festivity and its aftermath for ourselves. Along the way, we met partygoers past and present, as well as Thai locals working to balance profit and preservation on their beautiful island.
We're still pretty early on in our life as an island with tourism. We've only been having tourism, say, really not much more than 20 years. There are different sections to the whole island. And what I mean is, like, well, we have the full moon party, right? And that's the southernmost tip. It's one of the most beautiful little peninsulas out there, and beach, as you saw. Koh Phangan has many faces. You know, the whole east coast is still, we don't have a road out there. We have humongous jungle trees and rainforest trees up in the national park, which a little more than 50% of our island is national park. So we're really pushing for the status of an eco-friendly island. So how to mesh that with eco-friendly island with full moon party, which is one of the, you know, this has been our challenge. And it's only this last 5 years that we've had this amount of people. Before that, we had a lot of bohemian style backpackers, and they were actually a lot better with taking care of the nature, you know, because I think that's something to tie to their culture.
We were heading to Koh Phangan at that time to go to somewhere completely unspoiled. So the party was really small at that time. It was people who wanted to get away from the materialism in really Britain, Germany, United States. Groups of people had sort of broken away from the mainstream, and they were called by the press New Age hippie travelers. And often living in trucks, having raves in fields in their own countries. And then there were sort of offshoots of that in Goa, Arambol, Vagator beaches at that time, always sort of living in grass huts, trying to get as far away from the mainstream consumer society as possible. And then Koh Phangan was the next offshoot of that. Certainly the sense I got at the time was that these parties sort of evolved out of people's desire to dance in the open air. That was really partly what united us, dance music and ecology. So we weren't actually the hippies at all, because the hippies didn't like dance music. They were all playing lutes and stuff.
The people that were here before were more kind of hippie-ish, kind of knew what was going on. And then since commerciality came onto it, like, a lot of people just come here for the party, so people just don't really care. They just want to come here to get drunk and have a good time. No one really cares of the kind of the message that was there before, which I kind of understand that was have a good time, but also be conscious of what was here before, so.
I have a sense that it didn't start like as an item to be packaged as a full moon party. It was more spontaneous than that. In 93, before the road went through, when we went there, it was, you really were going into the sort of home place, the land of people who'd lived there for generations, really aware of that, and really aware of this incredibly beautiful and special place that they were sharing with us.
When I was there in 2002, it seemed like there was enough of a certain amount of pride in where it was and fortune and, you know, just being able to be there and be in that special place, part of your job was to look after it.
But now we're getting, holiday tourists for the first time coming to visit, and they are, they still good. They still have that in their mind, but sometimes I think with the alcohol and other things that they lose sight of what's really important. It's very natural for us because if you know about, like for example, yin and yang, these two things go together. You know, we have the yin side is the nature, and then the yang is the party and the festivities, and Thailand is known for that. It's known for having some of the best parties in the world, and full moon party leaves nobody disappointed. You know, it's an event.
In the club, party rock. Looking for your girl, she on my jock, huh? Now stop when we in the spot. Booty moving weight like she on the block. With a drink, I got to know. Tight jeans, tattoo, cause I'm rock, rock. Half black, half white, diamond, no. Gang of money.
Yeah, I'm running through these halls like Trano. I got that devilish flow, rock and roll, no halo. We party rock. Yeah, that's the clue that I'm repping on a rise to the top. No letting our Zeppelin.
Hey, party rock is in the house tonight. Woo. Everybody just have a good time.
Yeah,
and we gon' make you lose your mind. Everybody just have a good time.
Let's go.
Party rock is in the house tonight. Everybody just have a good time.
Feel it, baby.
And we gon' make you lose your mind. We just wanna see you
shake that. Shake that. I think for the impact and for the mess during full moon party, we got, for example, bottle, beer bottle, and many, many garbage things. And we really concerned about it, and we try to figure it out how we can keep it clean. If we not catch up in time, it's going to go to the tide and go down to the sea. And I think, I don't know, right now, how many of them under the sea and where it go. But we really concerned about to stop them go in the sea.
And if you go to full moon party and you look under that ocean, there's a lot of plastic straws. I've done that before. And there's a lot of plastic straws under there. And that's, for us, yeah, something that we want to deal with and change. So we've had to really clean up after the party, and we're doing better. 4 years ago, I'm a beach volleyball player, and 4 years ago, if you used to make just a square meter in the sand, you would find so much bottle caps and cigarettes and maybe pieces of broken bottles and stuff. And people were getting injured and a lot of bad social ills. Fish were dying because of the cigarettes getting lodged in their throats, and we even had a dolphin at one time. That really broke a lot of people's heart. We had a dolphin roll up to the beach, and it was, wow, and it smelled, and it was terrible. And then at that time, we say, really, something needs to be done.
So lately, we set the business of Hadrin's Association, and we try to, after full moon party, right away, we try to have a group of the people to pick up the bottle and garbage and clean up the beach. We really serious and concentration on doing this for a year already, and we can see the improvement of the cleanliness of the beach. I think the people in Hadrin area take all the responsibility of the keeping the beach clean.
ถ้าเป็นไปได้อยากให้ทำกฎของหาดลินนี้ให้มีกฎว่าถ้าทำความสะอาดถ้าทำความสกปรกอาจจะต้องมีการเก็บเงินกันบ้างปรับเสียค่าปรับแต่ช่วงแรกๆคิดว่าน่าจะบอกให้เขารู้ก่อนว่าคุณต้องเรามีถังขยะให้แล้วนะต่อไปเราจะมีถังขยะทุกร้อยเมตรหรือว่ายังไงก็ให้ช่วยเอาไปทิ้งถังขยะหน่อยแต่ในเมื่อเกิดว่าขอร้องไม่ได้อาจจะต้องมีบทลงโทษกันบ้าง น่าจะอย่างนั้นดีกว่า
There's some areas likeLet's say Singapore and even portions of Bangkok, where they'll fine you for littering, you know. And here in Koh Phangan, we don't really feel that's necessary at this time. We don't want to really police the party in that way, and we don't really want to police the people in that way.
It's easy to pin it on the business owners, I think, or just to say, well, the community should police this themselves when.You know, when you're looking at the almighty dollar, it's hard to make that decision. So ultimately, it's got to be self-responsibility for the guest, the visitor, the tourist. It's got to be made clear that that's their responsibility to clean up after themselves and to not be wasteful.
The problem with the beach over here is that the locals see it on a day-to-day basis, but the people who are actually funding this community don't see on a day-to-day basis because they're only coming here for one day at a time, maybe one month at a time. They might come once, twice, three times in a lifetime. So the people, do they really give one about dropping something or not? Probably not.
In festival culture here, that you go to a music festival like Bonnaroo or Coachella or something, Wakarusa, and after the night, there's garbage, cups and stuff everywhere because they hire people to clean it up. You know, there's not an expectation that if you use something, you take care of it. You go to Burning Man, and if you throw a cigarette butt on the ground, you're gonna have 5-10 people who are like, hey buddy, you know, not cool, pick that up. There's a certain amount of self-responsibility and community alliance that says, this is okay, this is not okay.
If they were made a lot more apparent that there was more like trash bins around, then people hopefully use them more, but at the moment people are a bit blasé by using them.
There needs to be more bins, more rubbish bins for all the bottles, plastic, beer bottles. This needs to be cleaner. If we could get more bins on this beach, it'd be fine.
Rapid development in Thailand and on the island of Koh Phangan has played its own role in the full moon party's changing culture and scene. In 1989, the first 7-Eleven opened its doors in Bangkok. By 2013, there were nearly 7,000 stores throughout the country with plans for more, giving Thailand the third greatest number of 7-Eleven stores behind Japan and the United States.
Since 7-Eleven moved in, our famous 7-Eleven and their big gulps. Since they've moved in, they brought a lot of plastic to the island with them. And sometimes we can't contend with all that plastic. And they always pass out plastic bags on every purchase. And we don't think that's necessary, you know. And so we're getting a large portion of plastic that we're having to contend with. And in a small island, that's, you know, some problem. We have landfills, but who wants to build a landfill on a beautiful paradise? Certainly I don't want to, but we have to in some cases.
A lot of it is just waste that maybe doesn't even need to be used in the first place. Plastic bags, straws, really just horribly wasteful petroleum products that we kind of take for granted. And what does it take to stop that? Well, for the community to decide that's not what they want. And it's hard if that's what's making them money, for them to go against their best interest of making money and realize that their best interest really is saving the island and saving the beach. They're going to have to realize that that's the most important thing, is to take care of the place so people will keep coming if that's how they want their island to be used. Unfortunately, what will happen is people will move on. They'll say, well, this place is trash now. Let's find another place to party. Let's go to Tong Sai. Let's go to this place. Let's go to this place. And it'll be this vicious cycle of using up one resource and going to another one.
Those of us who went there at that time, and for whom the road was then cut through that beautiful forest, in some sense bear a responsibility. I think a lot of us feel that, but things have taken off so fast that the question is, how can you clear it up? You can't turn back the clock. You can't say you wish we'd never been, and that it had never started, and that beach had never become that. But I think people are genuinely trying to set up organizations and things that can undo the kind of environmental damage. But maybe the point or the lesson that we can learn from that is that it's much easier to set it in motion. You know, you can't turn back that rock. We rolled the rock down the hill and it just carried on and on and on, and now it's this huge problem. It does seem to be a much bigger problem to fix than it was to create.
So what we encourage is self-responsibility. You know, we really want people to take a conscious effort that when they're going to go party, when they're going to, you know, that they're still going to remember what's important to them, and how important keeping the nature intact is for the whole world these days. You know, we've seen things in the media, you know, in other countries, like oil spills of the Gulf of Mexico to, you know, Chernobyl, and how, you know, if you don't respect the nature, it'll come back to haunt you.
Butts in your beer bottle. I mean, it's not that hard. So yeah, just try, everybody, just try.
A chocolate mushroom shake, and it blew my head off, and it was really good. Your eyes are pretty big, aren't they?